Hey everybody, thanks for being here. Today we're in Northern California on Lake Oroville fishing for landlocked King Salmon, probably one of California's best up-and-coming fisheries. Now if you want to learn how to catch more fish, stay tuned.
I'm Justin Wolf, and this is Angler West Television. Major drainage of the Sierra Nevada mountains, the Feather River finds the Sacramento Valley near Oroville, California. And with the construction of Oroville Dam, Lake Oroville gives us some great fishing opportunities. Probably the most famous for its spotted bass, Oroville now holds a solid population of landlocked king salmon, planted by Fish and Game in recent years. Those fish have grown quickly to catchable size, and the future is bright for Oroville salmon. Today we're after those landlocked king salmon with local angler Mike Tripp, his son Ryan, and Brett Brady of Bare Bones Guide Service.
So 80 feet deep, seeing a bunch of bait on the bottom. You can see one king there at 45. Pond smelt are typically pretty heavy in the morning, and for what we're seeing, it could be a good day. The 45 to 80 feet has been the prime target area for these kings lately. Good Oroville setup, Shasta tackle, UV sling blade, about an 18 inch leader, and the green Pee-wee Hoochie has been a hot ticket here lately.
On this rod, we're running a 6 inch sling blade with about a 24 inch leader to a wiggle Hoochie with a green splatter paint. This one's been killing the kings up here lately. See how we do today.
Set back today about 10 to 20 feet. Kings aren't boat shy. The downrigger actually attracts them to the boat. So for speed, we're doing about 2 miles an hour. The Shasta tackle sling blades will handle this speed. Anything up to about 3.3.
They're right there, they just came up. Look out, see them, boy, right there?
So 125 foot fish. So you can see our rigger line right at 50 feet. And being the short setbacks we're using, that king is directly under the boat.
So,
for some reason, the kings really adapted the structure here at Oroville. That is one of the main keys of fishing this lake. In the morning, the bait will be out over open water, but as the sun comes up, they'll start looking for that structure to try to get away from these fish. The downrigger weights that we use are more adapt to that. The stick weights, we call them. They're basically either rebar, I make mine out of copper. They just help bounce off the rocks where a lead ball would just get trapped in between the rocks. If you progress towards structure and stay on it, it makes a huge difference fishing Oroville. Coming here tight. This point primarily was our do-it point the last time. From here up to the orange buoy, up at the far end of the wall.
Yeah, I didn't have to come out.
A lot of little bait balls in here. Nothing major, just a lot of little guys. I don't know, the low light never seems to fire real good on this lake. I mean, I call them banker's fish. You can get here at 9 o'clock and do great. No reason to be here at O Dark 100. So the king salmon at Lake Oroville used to be here in the 90s. The lake started running into some problems with the fish getting sick. So they stopped the program for a few years. Then we had cohos introduced into the lake. All the cohos were being bought, raised here at the Feather River Hatchery and planted. That was a great program for about 6-7 years. Then they started getting out of the lake. A couple fish were found on the Yuba River and kind of sent a red flag to the people that mattered, and they were worried about the out-of-state coho mixing with the native population in the rivers and in the ocean. So there went our coho program.
We went about a year with no fish in the lake at all. Then they started introducing the king salmon back into the lake in spring of 2013. And this will be our fourth year of plants this November.
This is on the far setback. Seeing the fish jumping on the surface, put it back into them. Way back there.
Trying to get those surface fish. Ryan, what depth was that at?
Yeah, that was a 30.
At that 30, we had a 100-foot setback.
Well, I guess all the fish jumping on the surface were bass this morning. Had to find out.
You're eating cold water spots.
Not what we're looking for.
Welcome back to Lake Oroville. I'm Justin Wolf. We're after landlocked king salmon with Shasta tackle, sling blades, and hoochies, but so far we've only hooked bass, so it's time to make a move.
So we gave it a shot here on the mouth of the North Fork, and all that want to play is bass. So we're going to make a move over to the Green Bridge that's been productive also, and try to locate these fish.
We're running the same setup, but we're running a little chunk of chovy on there just to give it some added scent.
Guess which flavor? Bloody tuna. So we're putting on little chunks of anchovy. Really makes a difference, that added flavor. Then up inside the skirt, just a little shot of Anna's bloody tuna. Garlic has its days. Short setbacks, 20 feet on the side riggers and 10 feet on the back rods. So what we're doing here for these kings up here at Lake Oroville is we're taking leftover anchovies and curing them in a brine and bite with a little bit of added salt, then chunking them up. Fish on, 60-foot rod. Number four. Is he on? He's on, pop it off.
Maybe we get a double, Ryan.
Is he on?
Can't feel him yet.
Yeah, he's gone. Ryan, still got him?
Yep, still got mine. Pulling.
Yeah, he's gone.
This one's gone.
Flipped it.
There he is.
The chunker.
Or we like kings.
Both hooks in his mouth.
He ate it.
This is the green peewee hoochie behind the 6-inch UV blue sling blade. This one was down at 60 feet and both hooks buried in the mouth. They're hungry. This guy here is about 16 inches. This is our average king in here right now. There's fish all the way up to 5 pounds, which we're hoping to see today. But 16, 17 inches is about the upper size for these fish, but get an idea, a year ago these things were put in at 5 inches, so not a bad growth rate.
We're gonna do it again. We gotta set them all up. Green's been working good.
So we've got bait balls down at 70. We've had fish from 45 to 60. We're out here just shy of the Green Bridge in between Bidwell Point and the houseboats. Little wind chop on the lake, which does help. So the kings and trout in our lakes are really bound by water temperature. This little device produced by Fishhawk is a device you can either hook onto your rod or hook onto your downrigger. It shows depth increments with temperature combined with it, and it'll show max depth reached. So right now up here at Oroville, just to give you an idea, 0 feet, we are 72 degrees. Right now for kings, I'm looking for 50 degrees, 48 to 52 degrees. The best bite's been 45 to 60. So if I had my best guess, we're in around the 50 degree mark around those temps. So right now, keep scrolling down. 45 feet, we're 53 degrees, 50 feet, we're 51. So that's right where these fish should be. 55, 60 feet, we're 50 degrees on the nose. So as we drop down, colder and colder and colder, 120 feet, 48 degrees. So anywhere right now, these kings can still be down to 150 feet. So the way the device works is I attach this to my downrigger, hit the start button, and you just drop your downrigger down through the water column. I'll drop it down to 200 feet just to see what the temps are doing.
No, this could take a while to get them in.
Next spring will be fun.
Oh, yeah, that's going to be great.
3-4 pounders.
These are fun.
Sideways.
These are fun.
So back on the green Hoochie, that one was down at 75 feet.
Which side you want?
Middle.
Middle? Coming in. Oh, not wanting to come in.
Over to the right hand side, dude.
He turned the boat on.
Ready?
And he's in the middle. We got a 50-foot fish on the screen.
Chunky or
that's a
really
chunky,
green.
Huh? Nice.
So far, our move to the main body of Lake Oroville has been productive, but that doesn't mean that we can't experiment with different presentations that might even be more productive.
Changing up to something a little brighter. The water's really green right now. And just kind of shooting in the dark. But it has worked good in the past. Give it a little bit of bend. The beauty about a sling blade is they're infinitely adjustable. The depths, 45 to 80 feet, have been pretty consistent out here. Right now, the two fish we have in the box, one came from 75, one came from 45. I'm finally starting to see fish on the screen. At 60 foot seems to be a prime number. But so far, everything's been above it and below it.
He poked at the 75, and then that's when you drop that speed.
Yeah.
And then that's when I was telling you, you know, to jack it back up because he's got to get it. He did.
See, another thing that we do is you pull on the retroweave cables, kind of give it that little shutter down there to make sure you can get your hookups.
So that fish was at 75, and he hit us, but he didn't get it. So we slowed the boat down, dropped the rigs down, and as the Dodger that was floating at 60 dropped down into that same range, he picked up that one. But he wanted to see it a little bit different. There you go. Got my net man ready. He has yet to miss one, right, Ryan? Always a first time? Heck no, not today. Hey, and he's in. That's a nice catch. Hey, check out that hooch, huh? When all things fail, change it up. So all we did was change out the hooch. We've been running a lot of UV colors and lighter color. So we went to a darker color. And he grabbed.
So it's a great looking fish now for fall. But these fish are going to grow another year, year and a half. So by next spring, I'm expecting 18 to 20 inch fish out of these fish. All right, made another move. Came back here to the tip of the North Fork. It's been a good mid-morning spot. Obviously, it didn't pan out this morning. We're going to be sticking a lot tighter to structure now because the open water fisheries produced us a couple, but it should be a lot better.
You ready, Ryan?
So behind the Shasta Tackle Sling Blade, we're running a Berkeley Power Minnow. It's just a dead-on imitation for these pond spout in this lake. This is a little inch and a half, running it on a number 2 light wire bass worm hook, simple rig. That fish came from 55 feet deep, over 80 feet of water when we pick up that fish. We've had bait balls down at 100 feet, sitting right on the structure. So these are Japanese pond smelt, which are in both Oroville and Almanor. Originally, we had shad in Oroville years ago, and I think they just slowly been pushed out and died off by the pond smelt. And we've seen clouds the size of houses in this lake in the springtime just under the surface. It's a great forage fish. They're not a deep dwelling bait fish, so I think that's what keeps these kings relatively shallow throughout the year.
Now we're catching. Oh, that's a good one.
Seen that fish on the graph at 60, had the lines at 55, dropped it down to 60, and bam, whacked it. Sling blade power minnow.
I'm getting slow in my old age.
Bam, right there. How many have we lost? Not a lot. And we got our last two fish on the scent chamber of magic bloody tuna. And we're gonna sauce them up here again and see if we can't pull another one. And he's ready to go. You got your dodger or sling blade running at its constant speed. We get in a cadence. See how that, just that kick right there. So the fish will line up on that and he'll just sit back there smelling it, won't hit it. So we gotta fire that fish off by changing that cadence, and we'll gotta get a reactionary bite out of it. Either we speed it up to where it kicks harder and faster, or we'll slow it down and let it drop back down into his face.
I hope you're enjoying today's episode from Lake Oroville, where we're catching landlocked king or chinook salmon, mostly with Shasta tackle sling blades and peewee hoochies. Now, a sling blade's great because it's tunable. If you want to troll as fast as it'll go, then leave it flat like this. If you want to slow down and get more action on your lure, then just give it a little bend. You can give it a severe bend, but you got to be careful you don't go too fast in and it'll start rolling on you. Or you can tune it just how you want it, or bring it back to being flat. So the fish are going to dictate how you run your dodger. Now this is one of my hoochies here that I've caught a lot of fish on, and I've added a smile blade to it. I really believe in the smile blades. You might give them a try sometime. Now let's go back to Lake Oroville and catch some more fish.
So that's
see if
you'll
choke up anything.
Two fish, five strikes right there.
Yep. Nothing?
How long were we here this morning?
Hour.
Without a hit.
Fish on, baby.
Raft don't lie.
Everyone, we've got off speed one way or another.
So if you want to take a, if you want to get in on this, so you can see this fish right up off a structure. You know, he's sitting right here off a main point.
I'm gonna come on that side, Ryan. I should be able to get him right in. In order to get those things to strike out, if you off speed that lure, constant cadence back there, he'll just come on in, line up on it, he won't take it.
Yeah, we've
off speed it, speed it up, slow it down, and it'll get the reaction bite out of it.
Yeah, we've videoed cohos on the GoPro following it for 5-6 minutes before they'll commit to it, and they usually commit once you do a turn.
Look at the flower day. Let's get him a little closer, right?
Nice to meet
you. He is, Dad. I see how you look. Yeah, that's what that long net handle's for. There he is. Hey. Huh? What do you think? Not bad.
On that funky color.
Huh, isn't that something? We just dropped that down again. Nice fish.
24-inch leader. The reason I like the longer leader, you get away from your dodger, you get less action out of your bait. Another way to get less action, go to lighter line, more action, heavier line. Just sometimes these fish just want it dragging back there, and sometimes they want that pulse of what that dodger's applying to it. I mean, I'll run 10-inch leaders on these. It all depends on what the fish want. Landlocked kings are still a king. They go through their 3-year life cycle. They're eating bait. What we don't know is what they do when they disappear. Fish Shasta quite a bit. I fished Don Pedro. Oroville's still a relatively new fishery. Every lake has been different in some aspects. Shasta's real deep on the fishery. Oroville is a lot colder lake at the depths, so we're not having the fish as deep. But even as much landlocked king fishing I've done, I still haven't figured out where these fish migrate to, what they do, you know, at the end of their life cycle. I have caught a couple what I would call spawning kings out of Shasta that were just real dull in color. You know, I don't think they do the same as a river king where they're changing colors because they haven't been to salt water and back. But the one thing that we have found out that is kings are similar to kokanee is that they seem to migrate sometimes back to where they were planted. I've seen that in Shasta where they've planted them at the Ceremony Boat Launch, Packers Bay, and usually a lot of these bigger kings are they seem to come from the bass guys up in the shallows.
You got a bass for me? Is that what you got?
Green carp.
You got a bass. You made me get a net for a bass, didn't you? Yeah, even they like those green hoochies. New bass bait for Oroville.
Get him, Ryan, get him. Found him.
Six-inch sling blade, power minnow.
Brad, as soon as we came over that last point, all that bait sitting down at 110
on our bottom. Side. Our side, huh?
Yes, this side of
yeah.
It.
Hey, thanks for watching today's episode. You know, without the support of the sponsors, the show would not be possible. So please thank them when you can. Now, get out there and do some great fishing.